grace you in peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Our text for today is the Gospel just read, taken from St. John chapter 1. Have you ever had that experience where you walk into a room with great purpose and intention, and then it's gone? Why am I here? What am I trying to accomplish as I walked into this room? Every once in a while, we have these moments when we lose our way. Call it a senior moment, call it whatever you like, but sometimes we just forget what the point is, why we are here in the first place. What would happen if the church lost its way? What would happen if the church forgot who we are, what its purpose is, why we come here and do all of this stuff, Sunday after Sunday after Sunday? It's not that hard to imagine, I don't think. We are, after all, creatures of habit above all. We come to do things because, well, because that's what I do. And sometimes I don't even know or understand why I'm doing them in the first place. Very often when it comes to church, we forget what the point is. We forget why we're here. We forget even more, and perhaps even more disturbing, what it means to be a Christian. What the point of the whole thing is. It can become just another thing that we kind of tick off on a busy weekend's list of things to do. So, what is the problem? Why does this happen to us? And it does. Make no mistake. Every church, every Christian, every one of us kind of loses our way. We forget our purpose. We forget what is going on all the time. This is, of course, exactly a picture of the fall into sin, isn't it? Adam and Eve lost their way. They forgot their purpose, which was to love one another, to be loved by God. And so, in a moment of desire, they forgot who they were and what it meant to be human in the first place. Now, this is something that I really like about John. If there's one thing we know about John kind of knows who he is. You don't walk around in camel's hair eating locusts and wild honey with an uncertain view of your place in the world. So these people come to John with this question: who are you? Why are you here? Why are you baptizing? Why are you doing all of these things that you do? And that question is very much like the question that we must ask ourselves as a congregation, as a church, as a people. Why am I here? What am I doing? What is my point? Now, what I especially like about how John answers this question is that he really starts by saying who he is not. I am not the Messiah. I'm not Elijah. I'm not that prophet. I am none of those things. And for you and me, to be freed from thinking you're something you're not is a great gift. Stop me if you've heard this before, but you are not God. You are not the one that controls the wind and the waves. You are not the one that can make sense of everything in the world. You can't. That's not who you are. And to free yourself, or maybe better, to be freed of that notion is an incredible relief. I can't control everything. I can't even control myself, far less anyone else. I can't free myself from my sin. I cannot make everything right which was made wrong. Recognize that in who you are, and you will be a much happier person, believe me. But of course, it doesn't stop there, does it? Not only does John recognize who he is not, he knows who he is. He is the voice. He is the finger pointing the way. Right after our reading this morning, there's one more verse where John sees Jesus coming and points to him and says, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." That is John's place. He is the finger pointer. He is the one that shows us who we are not, and even more importantly, who Jesus is. Isaiah 2 points the way. The Lord has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. As that verse from Isaiah 61 begins, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to release the captives, to set prisoners free, to forgive, to heal, to raise the dead. That's who Jesus is. That is, after all, what Advent is all about. And John deliciously points us to that great reality. That the one is coming. And that he is the one who comes to free us from our sins. To free us from our selfishness, to free us from our self-righteousness, to help us find our place in the world once again. A place that we seem to have lost, like walking into the garage when you forget what you were looking for in the first place. And so, this day, rejoice that you have a Savior. A real Savior who comes into this very real, broken, messed up world. Who comes to free you from your sins. Who comes to free you from being something that you're not. And remember this. Who you are is a big deal. Who you are is a child of God. Loved by God. Who you are is one that Christ came to die for, so that you might live. That you are of infinite worth to God. Free yourself from thinking that it is all about you, and be free to realize that Christ has come to save you, and to save all of those who are around you. Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in true faith for life everlasting.
Amen.
We rise.